Hello, everybody. Just getting set. Sorry, I'm gonna get a couple of different windows pulled. There we go. I'm gonna need to keep that one. There we go. Okay. Hey. So, getting everything squared away. I've got a lot going on. Sorry, we're doing a lot of stuff from my bed today. Ugh. My back has decided to be a little bit craptastic, and my circadian rhythm is completely off. Fun times. If you don't know what a circadian rhythm is, it is your normal sleep and wake cycles. And I mean, mine are already kind of crap because I have insomnia, have my entire life basically, but it's been especially not great recently because, you know, all of the stuff going on, including the stress and the whatnot. But yeah, no, last night darned if I know. But it was really bad, and I did not get to sleep until, I want to say, 5 a.m., which is probably part of the reason I'm having so much trouble getting up in the mornings and being functional before noon. But way above and beyond that, I've been doing my next round of face masks. If you saw my original Shinobi-styled mask, I'm making more of them. And people have really been wanting them, and I had an order of like 13, so I'm getting those put together. Pardon me as I sit up. I'll move this just a little bit more so you can see it. So yeah, I'm sure you can see all of my bits and pieces and whatnot. Bringing it over just a touch. There we go. Okay, so we've got some odd angles set up. So this is the mask. This is the inside out portion. And you can see that there's a strip of wire. It's actually a heavy duty floral wire, and it can be, pushed and bent around the nose. That way it actually forms a better seal, for when the mask is being worn, because instead of wearing the mask as just straight across behind the ears and behind the jawline, which is a lot of what those masks do, and then, you know, you also have the small, thin surgical mask. I noticed a really bad issue of slippage or people not wearing them correctly. So they would slip down past the nose, which makes them useless, or would come up past the mouth, which, again, makes them pretty useless. Because the nose is where you're most likely to kind of take in the illness that's going around, and the mouth is the most likely point of expiration for the illness that's going around. So the best thing to do is have something that fully covers and stays in place. So if you can wear one of those little masks and it stays in place, absolutely run with it. Don't feel like you have to do so much more. But I like, I think it's called the N99, the N99 styled mask, or the Shinobi style mask, I need to blink more, anyways, those fit full coverage, so they almost wrap around the head, as it were, and it covers, most of the entry or exit points for, disease. Only leaving the eyes open. Now, if you really want to wear goggles, I mean, that's totally up to you. I'm pretty sure apocalyptic wear is going to take off shortly. I've had coffee, pardon. But yeah, I like the full coverage mask. I wanted something that would actually fit underneath my chin as well as across my nose, across my face, to make sure that I was not being exposed to too many things. Now I've got to find all the different ones that. Okay, that needs. So I went ahead and I preformed a lot of little nose pieces, making sure to twist the ends of them in so that there's no like extraneous piece that might scrape or scratch, because that would be very uncomfortable. Checking to make sure which ones need and which ones don't. So I have done quite a few of these. So yeah, I have a couple of light ideas that I want to do for more masks. I'm going through a lot of my fabric stores today, and while I have many very beautiful fabrics, not all of them are passing the candle test. And for me, the candle test is exceedingly important because the candle test tells me how much is getting out or how much can come in. And if I'm making something that's so somebody's going to be much safer when they're going out, I'm not going to leave them open to contamination, or at least I'm going to reduce that potential as much as I can. That's the problem with the surgical mask. There's a large gap above, and there's usually a pretty good gap down below where unfiltered air comes in or goes out. So that's an issue to me. Hence the reason I did this shinobi style. So it comes up under the chin and then here across the nose. I've also kind of sequestered myself or quarantined myself for about a week now. I have not really been outside. I thought I was having allergies, which I was, and they were super mild. But I'm like, I'm gonna stay inside just in case. And that's when I started going, okay, well, I need to come up with a better mask, something that I know that I can wear without the issues of slippage. So did the under the chin, and then did the elastic the same size so that part of it goes behind my head, from the jawline, or I'm sorry, from the ear line. But the other part down here, the jaw is a little bit loose, and that actually comes up and over. So it sits like a cross strap, and it keeps it from being able to shift itself or slip itself out of place, which was the problem that I was seeing quite frequently, with other masks being worn. So yeah, there you go. This is the mask. And like I see things now, like it's a good mask. It's absolutely a fabulous and wonderful mask, but my brain is always about design and, you know, whatnot. So I know where I want to make changes and where I want to do things a little bit differently. That still needs to be set into place. But yes, I have some done. Okay. Oh, I have three done already. I don't know why I only thought I had like two. Anyways, if anybody feels like ordering a mask from me, especially in this style, I have quite a bit more red fabric, and I'm going to be doing a black and red fabric. It's actually corsetry fabric. Beautiful, like even for its thinness, it is well woven, very, very tight. Very little air gets through it, and I have the coutil or the corsetry backing that is basically that same heavy, dense weave, and it's done in a twill fashion. Twill is actually a type of weave, so like twill tape has a kind of diagonal weave look to it. And that's exactly what it is. It's woven with a diagonal pattern and makes it really hard to tear, like exceedingly hard to tear. So even if it gets a minor hole or damage done to it, it doesn't shear. It stops itself, which is wonderful and fabulous. And that's the reason why I like that particular weave. Oh, sorry. Change something. Okay. So, yes. Really, today? Well, hello to Funkadelicious Jones, Red Fox 0526, and Zenny 972. Yes, and welcome to. Hey! So yeah, welcome to another part of my room, aka also my work room. My back is being a little shitty, so I'm in bed. Yay! But I've put together multiple masks. So it is my shinobi styled mask, and they have a wire in the bridge of the nose. I'm finishing out pieces, so I'm actually showing you guys some of the handwork. A lot of people can do those the little quick surgical masks. I'm doing something that is a little bit more full and has a higher coverage and a more of a filter rate to it. Because I'm all about not getting horrifyingly respiratorily ill. Rather frightening statistic out of New York today. The amount of cases that they have had resulting in fatality is at about 4% right now. And usually I'd say, 4% is not so bad. But it's, looking at overall numbers, 500,000 confirmed cases and then 22,000 deaths. So when you're at 4%, 5%, that's actually pretty impressive is the wrong word. Mildly disturbing is a better word for it, because if you have all the technology and science and everything, and you're still getting a 4% fatality rate, this is a pretty insidious little virus at that point. Now, if somehow this thing got up to Black Death levels, which was roughly 30%, that would be terrifying. Especially seeing as we have, all the technology, so we shouldn't be getting to that, but who knows if people don't follow quarantine rules, shit could go really sideways, to say the least. How are you doing today, Grammy? Sorry, thread likes to get wrapped up around the tag bars. Well, it looks like our West Coast governors are being smart, and they've formed a pact, and they are out. They're going to be standing together on this particular subject. Exactly. Yeah, the asymptomatic spread of it is probably the reason it is so dang scary, because you can go 2 to 14 days with hardly a symptom and then hits you like a train wreck. Or it could hit the next person because, person A didn't realize that they had it, and they spread it through person B through Z. So I've been playing a bit of Overwatch. I've been working on my bread recipes, which are coming out kind of decent. Bread is the hardest dang thing for me. I swear, it is absolutely my Achilles heel. But I did one that had a very slow proof to it, and it seems to have come out better. So, and I think I'm gonna start, doing some design work and also looking for other jobs, because I've realized taking this week off of doing delivery that I don't want to put myself in that kind of danger over the long haul, because it may be another couple of months of this. But I'm also starting to get a little cagey and a little stir crazy. So, A, I have to organize my room. B, I need to set up an online shop so people can actually see my wares. And also figure out some sort of an exercise routine, maybe yoga or something to that effect, because I want to be able to stretch the muscles, keep in some semblance of a shape. I get it, round is a shape, but I want to be, fit or fitter. I'm actually pretty freaking healthy, which is the odd thing. Yes, my immune system doesn't always love me, but no, I don't feel as on top as I did, say, like a week or so ago when I was out, running deliveries and whatnot. But yeah. Just it's all about figuring out which direction are we going with all their shit. I'm hoping that you've been doing okay. You're not at the university, right? You're with family? Trying to remember, I have a shit memory sometimes. Oh, and for those of you who don't know, I'm on Mob Crush, so it's a multi-platform streaming, so you're gonna hear me talking sometimes to people that you can't always see, and I will try and let you know what's going on. But yes. Think I might do some TikToks today. Oh, okay. Not bad, not bad. Well, that's good. Yeah, I've got quite a few friends who are all of their stuff is now online, so they are doing all kinds of classwork and stuff. Ugh. Here I am just going, oh my God, I need to figure my shit out, because honestly, being quarantined like this and no tea, no shade, literally no tea, no shade, for my living situation, but I need my own place. I need my own space so I can do my thing. Of a feeling I was a village wise woman in times past. Oh. Yes. No, but yeah, no, I've also just been dealing with a lot of stuff that's been going on in my own head. Do, do, do. Sorry, a couple of different things. Wait, oh, you know what? Let me throw on. There we go. There we go. Okay, Nightbot is up, so if you're a subscriber on Twitch, you should be able to throw on songs if you want to. Feel free to have at that. Yes. So yes, for those of you who do not know me, I am a chatty person. But yeah, I love to be able to talk with people, and it's all about the exchange. It's about being able to connect. I do have a degree of psychology. I also do have a degree of fashion design. Hence the reason you see me sometimes drafting my own stuff or, doing different things. I do a lot of artwork, advice giving, the whole nine. And for me, my channels, my space is meant for community, is meant for talking and exchanging ideas and whatnot. I myself, quite specifically, I myself am pansexual, and I am part of the LGBTQ community, and therefore, be polite, be respectful. You can, of course, ask questions, but if somebody says, hey, I don't feel like answering that question. I feel it's too personal or it's very inappropriate or just not my whatever. Okay, cool. And respect that, please. But by, the same turn, if you want to ask a question and you are genuine about it, then by all means ask the question, because I don't have any problem usually answering questions if they are genuine. I feel they're disingenuous. Well, that's a different matter, of course. But yes, you'll hear me quite often talk to Grammy Norma or MK Ultra or Lu Cosmic Lulu. I have quite a few regulars from Twitch that I speak to on a pretty frequent basis, and you'll get to know and love them as much as I have gotten to know and love them. They're good people. Apparently I've got a decent following going on in the UK, which is funny to me, but I love it. Sorry, I'm attaching the bar tags. I will double check just to make sure that. Okay. Turn it up just a little bit. Let me know if you're hearing a loop or a reverb, because I might need to plug in my earphones just so it doesn't do that.
backseat, I'm your baby. We go fast, we go so fast, we don't move. I believe in a place you take me, make you real proud of your baby. In your car, I'm a star and I'm burning through you. In your car, I'm a star and I'm burning through you. Oh, be my once in a lifetime. Lying on your chest, in my body dress, I'm a fucking mess, but I... Oh, thanks for the highlight. Baby, you're the best, pass the test and yes, now I'm here with you and I would like to think that you would stick around. You know that I just died to make you proud. The taste, the touch, the way we love, it all comes down to make the sound of our love song. Dream a dream, here's a scene, touch me anywhere, cause I'm your baby. Grab my waist, don't waste any part. I believe that you see me for who I am, so I spill my clothes on the floor of your new car. Is it safe to just be who we are? Is it safe to just be who we are? Lying on your chest, in my body dress, I'm a fucking mess, but I... Oh, thanks for the highlight. Baby, you're the best, pass the test and yes, now I'm here with you and I would like to think that you would stick around. The touch, the way we love, it all comes down to make the sound of our love song.
That is gorgeous. That is a very, very beautiful song. I mean, Lana Del Rey is just, I mean, a phenomenal musician. Great vocal strength and everything, but also really knows how to use that voice to intone a lot of emotion, which some songwriters, that's what they get dinged on, is that, yeah, it's got a catchy beat or whatever, but not always necessarily the emotion. And Lana Del Rey does just amazing quality work that really evokes response. I always love seeing what you guys are into, what really evokes response from you. Because, hey, me, I'm old school, a little bit different. I'm older than I look. I am older than I look. But yeah, I mean, there are just some sorts of good that absolutely transcend age or even style. Thank you very much for throwing that on. Oh, the absolute. Yeah, you know, that's actually a really good point. She has a very calming voice, very soothing voice. And it is quite helpful in many respects to kind of, calm you down, kind of recenter. Oh, come on. No, go ahead. As long as it's not over 10 minutes, you should be able to list it. And by all means, I mean, come on. Inagata Devita is like 12 minutes long. Jesus of Suburbia is like, I think, 7 or 8 minutes long. Length is not a bad thing.
Red. Sorry, I do have to shift my position quite a bit. I also don't speak quite as loud when music's on, but yeah, I think it's because it might be sharing a mic that it does that. Hey, Cosmic, how are you doing? It's been a minute. Say at least it's been a minute. Welcome to not just Twitch, but to Mob Crush. Branched out my platform to the world. I hear you on that. I was a childhood asthmatic with bronchial issues, to say the least. Oh my goodness, you poor thing. I feel your pain. I really, really do. I hope you've been safe. I hope you've been taking precautions. I know that I have. Yeah, I've been basically self-sequestered quarantine, not going out for like the last week because I had just like a little tickle going on. I was like, not taking the chance. I hear ya. Yeah, I've been working on bread recipes, and I've began to, I'm making shinobi-style face masks for people who need to, like, go out and about and whatnot. I've made one for myself, but I'm making some for others. Yeah, I hear ya. Like, there's just so much. Give it another week, I'll probably be doing yoga on stream. I'm stir crazy enough that I'm like, ugh, I just wanna exercise, I just wanna move and stretch, do things that require physical prowess.
Thank you.
this song to be very interesting, and it does have a very, it reminds me of Venice Beach. Those are actually two different things. They are a couple of miles apart. But there is quite a few walkways and trails and whatnot that connect Santa Monica Pier to Venice Beach. And I've actually walked from the pier to Venice Beach, spent quite a nice day there, and then Ubered my way back to my car because that is a... that is a walk and a half. I think I did 10 or 12 miles walking that day, and I was like, by that point, I was like, yeah, I just need to make it back to my car, because it's going to be like a 2-hour car ride home. If you go home in LA traffic, you're going to be there a while. You're going to be there a long while. To say the least. I think that's what people don't quite understand when it comes to Californians, especially the Californians that live near LA. Traffic is our bread and butter. We know it's going to happen, and we are buckled in for the long haul. So most people can't even imagine like putting up with traffic apparently for more than like 30 or 40 minutes at a time. And to us, that's a short morning commute. So yeah, Nightbot is up and running, so if you're a subscriber over on Twitch, you can feel free to drop into Nightbot and put in your requests for songs and whatnot. Oh, there it is. There we go. Okay. Getting everything squared. Away. I think I've got like 3 or 4 more, so at least one more red to do. But yeah, like my brain is chewing over the next style of mask I want to do. I've got this beautiful, I want to say it's almost like an Art Deco style of corsetry fabric that well passed the candle test. That I want to do really nice masks with. I'm just deciding what kind of lining I want to put in it. I think buckram will just malform itself and won't hold the way I want it to. And I don't want these masks to be purely decorative. So I may be going with a thick inner fusing, which will definitely make it even, you know, stronger as far as that goes. But I need to make sure that you can actually breathe through the particular interface that I have, because it is very, very thick. It's meant to act in place of buckram. So it might be too thick or... not permeable enough that you could breathe through it, which would be worrisome. But yes. Apparently for me, when I start to get stir crazy, I want to do more and more arts and crafts and baking and whatnot. But hey, welcome to my world.
Oh, has anybody seen like any good movies lately? Like a watch party of any sort? Because my Ionic girlfriend and I watched Outbreak and Train to Busan. Train to Busan is one of my I've had two friends so far tell me that apparently I am the Manticore from Onward. Is that on Disney Plus or is that like on a different service? Is there a way for The very fact that so many people thought this, I honestly probably need to do the cosplay at this point for the Manticore. I love it. I freaking love it. I freaking love it. Okay, where what service am I able to watch this on? Because I have to see this now. I mean, I saw a clip of it and I'm like, yeah, that does tend to fit, but where can I watch the entire thing? Like, is it on YouTube? Is it on Disney Plus? Which service do I need to get? Okay. Oh, so you saw this before. Oh. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Oh, okay. I may need to get Disney Plus for a month or something like that. That's a bit of comedy to me, but I'm also absolutely thrilled because like literally each friend who said this or thought this was very like separate from my other friends, so it's not like they could just go, oh yeah, you know, we were sitting around, we were all watching, blah blah blah, we were all talking, and oh yeah, we all kind of agreed. It was each one of them came to me and like, oh my God, this movie, you're the Manticore. This movie, you're the man. Three different people? What the hell, people? And then I saw a clip of them, like, they're not wrong. Oh, okay. Okay. I might just pick that up then. But yes. Do, do, do. There we are. Keep setting this up. Well, you know, if there's a 7-day trial, then maybe I should grab that and sit down and watch it. Because that'd be kind of fun. And, oh, you know what? Funny enough, I found some friend what's called friendly plastic. It's a moldable plastic. So I might actually be able to build my own tooth caps and do some foam work and whatnot, and actually create most of the costume here. Oh. Sorry, I had another thought process. I've got this beautiful red silk. I've got scraps of it that I was trying to figure out what I want to do with it, like if I wanted to cobble it together. But I also stumbled across some like kind of greenish colored suiting, like darker greenish olive drab suiting yesterday. So maybe while I'm doing all this sewing and designing and whatnot, maybe I can do like a Poison Ivy-esque outfit. Because she's doing a lot of black and green now, I can use the red for accent. Anywho, okay, let's see. Bartex. I think I just need to put like one more bar tack in, and then I can do some just regular stitching these things. I'll show you how to flip them around and whatnot. I think on the next batch I might actually do top stitching around the whole thing, because right now you can like iron them and they stay the way they are. It's not going anywhere. But I think on the next set I might do top stitching and whatnot. Okay. Okay. Ooh. Like my roommate's tiny chihuahua, who is the laziest little creature on earth and just tends to hang out with her because she's working from home. But yeah, I've got two roommates, and one of them actually has to go out to do work. I've been staying in for the last week, and then the third roommate is here working from home, so I can't be too loud or suck up too much bandwidth, because that causes a whole new set of problems. I need to take a quick my brain completely burr. I need to take a quick bio break, and I will be right back. Well, yes, maybe I can grab the tiny puppy. I gotta strip and redo the bed anyway, so. Ugh. I swear, whenever I get my own place, I don't know if I'll have animals, oddly enough. Don't know if I'll have animals. Although, if I did have an animal in my own place, crows or ravens. I mean, they'd probably be wild, they'd be outside, but I would encourage them to come around. I might keep one for myself. But if I had to choose between cats and dogs, I'd probably choose a dog. I'm a dog person, what can I say? And it would probably be a pit bull, an American pit bull. Because I love them. They're the sweetest, nicest, most wonderful freaking dogs. And honestly, I miss having a pit bull around. I really, really do. Oh, goodness gracious, there are some times I swear. And huge. No, I don't want to go out to the cold, cruel world. At least not till I finish these masks. Sorry, I'm also trying to explain technology to someone who, oddly enough, has even less technological savvy than myself. And I suck with technology. I am not tech savvy. I understand that. do 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 do. But yes. Not, it's been a while, honestly, since I've had a pet of my own. I miss having pets of my own. I really, really do. But yeah, when it comes down to animals, I tend to be a dog person. Or I like to encourage, you know, wildlife to be wildlife near where I'm living. And I have a special affinity for crows and for ravens, funny enough. What? Is that the name I go by? No, wait, yes it is. Yeah, it, ever since, you know, quarantine started going on and whatnot, since there's a lot less people traffic, I've seen and heard a lot more animals around. We've got a big murder of crows and ravens nearby. Blue jays, like you wouldn't believe. I didn't even know we had so many blue jays in Southern California, honestly. And just a metric ton of raccoons and skunks and other, you know, wildlife out and about, which has been pretty impressive, I'll have to say. You know, I don't mind cats, but I like lap cats. I like, you know, animals that are chill with being in small groups or in small packs. I don't like demanding animals that do damage to things, because I'm very particular about my things not being destroyed or maltreated or abused, and I have unfortunately had roommates who had really, really shitty pets. And they didn't reprimand those pets. They didn't teach them any sort of obedience. And those pets sometimes destroyed or damaged very expensive or very sentimental things to me. And it took everything I had not to make that pet into a new throw rug. So, yeah.
Sorry, again, trying to walk somebody else through this process.
But yeah, like, I understand the appeal of cats. I absolutely do understand the appeal of cats. Just for me personally, I've had cats try to destroy too many things because they didn't like that I was there and their master was neglecting them. So, of course, since I was the person who was active in the house and had things out, they destroyed my things versus going to, like, the master bedroom and destroying shit there. Because, you know, it's an animal. It doesn't have that logic. But yeah. Oh, man, that cat came really close to being a pair of slippers. I was not appreciative. Mostly because it tried to destroy a $1,000 Victorian ballroom gown that I was working on. And yeah, had it actually been able to damage that particular piece that I had been working on, bad shit. Yeah, no. That, you know what that is? That is a perfect description of it. It's this weird love, hate, I'm going to ignore you, pay attention to me kind of attitude that they have. It's like, look, Jesus, just for the love of shit, if you want me to pet you, let me pet you. Don't try and scratch the living fuck out of me, because well, certain types of cats are definitely more inclined to be in groups, and other types of cats are just much more inclined to be on their own. And I think that's the hard part, is finding a cat that is inclined to be sociable versus the cat that wants to be mostly on their own. And I'm very much if I'm going to have a pet, it needs to be a sociable creature. Because I am a sociable creature, even though I'm an introvert. So yeah, I guess maybe there's the difference. Her cat was definitely more of a loner type.
not a sociable type. Because, yeah, I think even with dogs, like, I don't get along with every dog. I especially don't seem to get along with small dogs. They just are not my bag. They are too skittish and they're barky little shits. It's like, look, let's have this discussion. Don't be a barky, bitey little shit and we're not going to have any problems. I will love you. I will love you a lot. But, you know, if I invite you on the bed, cool. If I am trying to work on something, though, I don't need you, you know, literally nipping at my ankles. I don't find that fun. But yeah, I mean, there are some just wonderful dogs who, you know, they can read you. I find the big dogs tend to read me better than the little dogs. Little dogs, kind of hit and miss more than anything. But big dogs tend to understand real quick, I'm the alpha bitch. I'm not doing anything I don't want to. You know, here's how it is. Here's how that's going to roll. This is what's going to happen. This is what's not going to happen kind of thing. But yeah. Right? Well, yeah, I can only compromise so far. But I do not compromise on certain things. And destruction of my property is like one of the biggest things that sets me off. And it doesn't matter whether an animal did it or whether a person did it. Like, my shit gets destroyed, I have fucking issues. Like, and it's that stems from a lot of other stuff. Well, damn. Sorry. Friend sent me a little bit of news. The Virginia pastor who defiantly held church service, I guess an Easter church or something like it. Oh, maybe not Easter, but a little bit. So I guess there were some people who continue to go to church and hold services and whatnot. Every time I hear about people holding church services or choir practice and whatnot, you then see a spike of these things. Well, apparently this particular pastor who went ahead and just went, I'm going to hold church services anyway, did so, and he just died of coronavirus. Quarantine, people, quarantine. Yeah. Yeah, and see, do not put it past me to, like, I won't say piss on a cat to show him whose territory it actually is. But yeah. I'm petty. I am exceedingly petty. Anyways, so I should show you the easy part of this. So now the bar tack for the nose is in. And it's literally just reach inside because there's this big gap at the top. Pull it right side out, and then basically tug on each of the corners of the strings, then everything will basically pop itself into place. And then I can iron it, and then when I ship them, I, fold them flat, put them into the envelope, and ship them. And then when a person gets them, they can reform the bar around their nose. So now all I have to do is take and stitch this top part of it shut, and it's good to go.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sometimes, like, big changes in their environment will definitely stress animals out. Because not only have they lived in, usually in that environment for a while, they've made it kind of their own, it has their scent. If you suddenly change it and take away everything that smells like them, it freaks them out, because it looks sort of the same. They know that they haven't gone anywhere, but now it doesn't smell like home anymore. So yeah, that can be very stressful, and that it can stress out cats, but it can also stress out dogs, because dogs don't always understand that, hey, we have this person coming in that you've never met before, and they're going to be here for a while making loud noises and funny smells, and then they're going to go away. They're like, I don't know what's going on, and they freak out. Poor things, Ugh, I feel so sorry for them. I feel bad for them. But yeah. Oh, man. Like, I used to think declawing a cat wasn't so bad. Mostly because I didn't understand exactly what it was. I thought they were just, carterizing the quick, so it didn't produce a claw anymore. I didn't realize that they were actually going in and basically amputating a piece of the paw itself, which made it really difficult for them to walk and for them to function. I did not realize that until a couple of years ago, when somebody broke it down with pictures and everything. Like, hey, it's not just that, hey, they're going in and they're like carterizing, like, you know how your fingernails. It wasn't like they were just carterizing the quick, so it wasn't producing a nail. They're actually taking out bone. It makes it really hard for them to walk. It makes it really painful and whatnot, and causes all these other things. I'm like, well, as much as I don't like my shit getting clawed to fucking back, somebody would come in and, chop off the first knuckle of your finger, and then you only had, half a finger to manipulate things with. Yes, your hands would be super sensitive and very difficult to be able to do anything with, and that'd be very frustrating and stressing, and it could cause other health issues. As much as I don't like them clawing up shit, I absolutely agree that something like a declawing procedure needs to be not legal, because that is just that's pain. That's a whole new level of pain. But the same way, I think that if you're going to have cats, you should not be able to let them be an outdoor cat. If you're going to own a cat, it should be an indoor cat. You should have ample space for it, ample enrichment for it. Keep it inside. People with the indoor-outdoor cats, I want to smack the living fuck out of them. I have a couple of friends who let their cats just roam however they see fit. And it really pisses me off, because cats are natural hunters. They are natural predators. And having a cat around means that you now have a predator. And if you just let it out to roam the neighborhood, guess what? It will target not just, mice and small vermin and whatnot. It targets birds, especially songbirds, and can decimate the bird population, which actually does a lot of harm to the environment. And since, you know, we've domesticated the cat and made it into this, you know, pet and spread them out across our great nation, that means that a lot of songbirds, a lot of birds, a lot of animals that help keep our environment balanced are being wiped out because of shitty pet owners who would rather let their cat out to run around and do shit rather than enriching the environment that they have in the house. And that pisses me off. Because you're fucking up the environment, honestly. Well, now, oh God, here's a big thing. Apparently, COVID can be spread to cats, and it can kill them. There's been a couple of cases that have been confirmed so far. I don't know if it's been confirmed as the COVID-19 virus. That's something that I'm trying to do some research on. But the fact that there seems to be a jump between felines and humans as far as this particular illness goes, that's worrisome. Because quite often illnesses don't tend to like to jump hosts. Or if they're going to jump hosts, they're hosts that are very closely related instead of being pretty far apart on the evolutionary chart. And, like mosquitoes, when they tend to spread stuff, they tend to spread things that are more or less host specific. Like malaria. Malaria's, from everything I've read so far, pretty host-specific to humans. So for something to be transferred from one species to another species and have about the same amount of detriment to them, that's interesting and a little bit scary. A little bit scary. But it is what it is. Not a problem. I was about to sign off myself. I've got to finish out doing masks and whatnot. Let's see, tomorrow's Tuesday. I will probably be on, I'm hoping I can get to bed at a decent hour. I will probably be on tomorrow morning around 9 or 10 o'clock till about noon. So, you know, the regular 2-hour cast. And we'll see about doing night casts and whatnot. But I hope everybody has a nice day. You guys are wonderful. You are awesome. I will see you all later. If you have any questions, requests, feel free to whisper me. Feel free to talk. I love doing this. If there are certain topics that you guys would like me to do some research and talk on and whatnot, please, by all means, I'm in quarantine anyways. So, you know, help me help you. And have a good one. Thank you all so much.